Hello students, in this video we have learned the concept of plot the characteristics curve throughput versus offered a traffic for slotted Aloha system. So this is the CN practical based on the concept of Aloha system. So Aloha is nothing but provides a wireless data network. It is a multiple access protocol. This protocol is for allocating a multiple access channel. There are main versions of Aloha, pure and slotted Aloha. They differ with respect to whether or not time is divided up into district slots into which all frames must fit. So first is pure Aloha. Pure Aloha is nothing but time consuming, means if time is continuous. In pure Aloha, users transmits whenever they have data to be sent. There will be collisions and the colliding frames will be damaged. Senders need some way to find out if this is the case. If the frames was destroyed, the sender just waits a random amount of time and send it again. The waiting time must be random or the same frames will collide over and over. In lockstep systems in which multiple users share a common channel in a way that can lead to conflicts are known as the contention of the systems. So the probability of no other traffic being initiated during the entire valuable period is by e-2g, which is leads to frames per frame time is the mean of position distribution with which frames are being generated. For reasonable throughput, S is divided into between 0 to 0.5. G is the mean of position distribution followed by transmission attempts per frame time, old and new combined. Old frames mean those frames that have previously suffered a collision. The maximum throughput occurs at G is equal to 0.5 with S 1/2E, which is about 0.184. In other words, the best we can hope for a channel utilization of 80%. So the result is not very encouraging, but with everyone transmitting at will, we would hardly have expected 100% success rate. Then second part is slotted Aloha. In slotted Aloha, time is divided up to district intervals, each intervals corresponding to one frame. In slotted Aloha, a computer is required to wait for beginning of the next slot in order to send the next packet. The probability of no other traffic being initiated during the entire value neighbor period is given by E minus G, which leads to S is equal to G into E minus G, where S is a frame per frame time, is position distribution with which frame are being generated. For reasonable throughput lies between 0 to 1. So G is mean of the position distribution followed by the transmission attempts per frame time, old and new combined. So old frames means those frames we have previously suffered a collisions. It is easy to note that slotted Aloha peaks at G1 with the throughput at 0.368. It means that if the system is operating at G is equal to 1, the probability of empty slot is 0.360. Now we will see the network setup. So first we will take the 4 laptops in the end devices, which is chosen for the end devices in the packet tracer tool. So laptop 0, laptop 1, laptop 2, laptop 3, laptop 4. Then we have taken one wireless devices. This is the WRT300N wireless devices. So after taken these all the end devices, first click on the WRT wireless devices. Just go to the config session and then go to the wireless session. So specify his name is SSID and set the WPA password for that 1234567 8, and for the internet choose on the DHCP configuration. So automatic IP address was generated for each laptop. Then go to the laptop 0, then go to the desktop and just click on PC wireless. So in that go to the connect, here refresh, click on refresh button. After clicking on refresh button, you will show that this the name of the SSID and the password, and just click on the connect button. Then we need to transfer. So in this way, we need to connect each laptop to the wireless router. After connecting the wireless router, we set the path from sending the packets from laptop 0 to laptop 2. And second path is from laptop 0 to laptop 3. Then select the protocols ARP and ICMP. Then start capture and forward. After capture and forward, the laptop 0 can send the packets to wireless router. Then wireless router can distribute that packet to all the remaining computers are connected that wireless LAN. Then particular machine can receive the packets. After receiving the packets, he will send the acknowledgement to the router. And again, router can accept the acknowledgement and transmit to all the stations those are connected in the wireless network. And the particular machine will get the receipts of that. So in this way, the machines from laptop 0 to send laptop 2, laptop 1, and particular laptops can send acknowledgement to router, then router again distribute all the stations related to that, and particulars can get the mark acknowledgement from sender to receiver and receiver to sender. Okay, thank you.